All right, everyone, let's talk testing. Specifically, test environments. Think of it like your perfect PC setup, but for software. You wouldn't run a demanding game on a 10-year-old PC, right? The same goes for testing software. A poorly configured test environment is like using that old PC, you won't get accurate results. And inaccurate results? That's a recipe for disaster. Imagine releasing software that hasn't been thoroughly tested in a proper environment. Bugs slip through the cracks, features malfunction, and users get frustrated. Not good. That's why having a reliable, consistent test environment is crucial. It's the foundation for delivering high-quality software. A good test environment mirrors real-world conditions. This allows developers to identify and fix issues before they reach the end user. Bottom line, solid testing equals reliable software. And who doesn't want that? Stay tuned as we dive deeper into the world of test environments. Okay, imagine this. You test a new feature. It works perfectly. You're stoked. You hand it off to QA and boom, it crashes and burns. What happened? Inconsistent test environments, that's what. This is a huge pain point in software development. One environment might have a slightly different configuration than another. Maybe a different operating system version, a missing dependency, who knows? These tiny discrepancies can cause massive headaches. And finding the culprit? It's like finding a needle in a haystack. Developers waste countless hours troubleshooting these inconsistencies instead of, you know, actually developing. It's frustrating, time-consuming, and frankly, avoidable. Let's talk dependencies. Think of them like ingredients for your software recipe. You need the right ones in the right versions for everything to work. But managing these dependencies, it can be a nightmare. Picture this, you're using a library to build a cool new feature. But then, another team updates that same library to a new version that's incompatible with your code. Suddenly, your feature breaks and you're stuck trying to fix it. This is what we call dependency hell. And trust me, it's as bad as it sounds. It's like trying to build a house on a foundation of jelly. Everything is shaky and prone to breaking. And when things break in software development, it's usually not a quick fix. Ever set up the perfect test environment only to find it gone the next day? Poof! Vanished. It's more common than you might think, especially in large teams where multiple people are spinning up and tearing down environments constantly. This can happen for a bunch of reasons. Maybe someone accidentally deleted it or the server it was running on crashed. Whatever the cause, it's a major disruption. You have to rebuild the entire environment from scratch, which takes time and effort. And time is money, right? This constant setup and teardown cycle eats into valuable development time. It's like having to rebuild your entire workstation every morning before you can start working. Not exactly productive. All right, enough with the scary stories. Managing test environments doesn't have to be a nightmare. Just like there's a tool for everything in your workshop, there are tools to wrangle these environments into shape. These tools automate tasks, improve consistency, and make everyone's lives easier. Think of them as your trusty sidekicks in the fight against buggy software. No more manual setup, no more dependency hell, just smooth, efficient testing. Now, I'm not going to bombard you with a million different tools. Instead, let's focus on the heavy hitters, the ones that'll make the biggest difference in your testing workflow. Get ready to level up your testing game. First up, we've got infrastructure as code, IAC. Sounds fancy, right? Don't worry, it's not as complicated as it sounds. Basically, it's like writing code to build your test environments instead of clicking around a bunch of menus. Think of it like this. You wouldn't build a house without a blueprint, right? IAC is the blueprint for your test environments. You define everything, servers, networks, software, and code. Then you use a tool to automatically build the environment based on that code. This means no more inconsistencies, no more manual configuration. Every environment is built exactly the same way, every single time. Plus, it's documented in code, so you can easily track changes and roll back to previous versions if needed. Pretty slick, huh? Next up, let's talk containers. No, not the ones you use to store leftovers. I'm talking about virtualized environments that package up your application and all its dependencies into a neat little box. Think of it like shipping a fragile item. You wouldn't just throw it in a box with no padding, right? You'd carefully package it with bubble wrap and packing peanuts to protect it during shipping. Containers are like that protective packaging for your software. Each container is isolated from the host system and other containers, so there are no conflicts. This means you can test your application in a clean, consistent environment without worrying about dependencies messing things up. Plus, containers are super portable, so you can easily move them between different machines and environments. Section 4, Configuration Management, keeping everything in sync. Last but not least, we have configuration management tools. These bad boys help you manage the configuration of your test environments, making sure everything is set up correctly and consistently across the board. Remember the nightmare of inconsistent environments? Configuration management tools are here to save the day. They automate the process of configuring servers, installing software, and applying updates. No more manual tweaking, no more discrepancies, just pure automated bliss. These tools also allow you to define configuration policies and enforce them across all your environments. So if someone tries to manually change a setting, the configuration management tool will automatically revert it back to the defined policy. It's like having a superpowered IT admin that never sleeps. Section 1, Real World Wins, Case Studies in Action. All right, enough theory. Let's dive into the real world and see how these tools and techniques play out in practice. We'll look at some case studies of companies that absolutely nailed their test environments and reaped the rewards. Get ready for some serious inspiration. These stories prove that investing in proper test environment management isn't just some abstract best practice. It's a game changer for businesses of all sizes. It's about delivering quality software, faster, and keeping your users happy. Who wouldn't want that? So buckle up. We're about to explore how companies from different industries tackled their unique testing challenges and emerged victorious. Get ready to learn from the best. Section 2, the e-commerce giant scaling testing to the max. First up, let's talk about a global e-commerce giant. You know the one, they sell everything under the sun. They have millions of users, handle billions of dollars in transactions, and their website needs to be up and running 24/7. No pressure, right? Now imagine trying to test new features and updates for a website that massive. It's not like they can just push changes to their live site and hope for the best. One tiny bug could cost them millions in lost revenue and damage their reputation. Their solution? Infrastructure as code and containerization. They used IAC tools to build out identical test environments that mirrored their production environment. Then, they containerized their applications and deployed them to these test environments for thorough testing. This allowed them to scale their testing efforts massively, running hundreds of tests in parallel across multiple environments. They were able to catch bugs early, ensure the stability of their platform, and confidently deploy new features to their millions of users worldwide. Section 3, the streaming service, keeping the content flowing. Next, let's talk about a popular streaming service, you know, the one with all your favorite shows and movies. They stream content to millions of subscribers simultaneously, and any downtime or buffering issues would be a PR nightmare. Testing for a streaming service is particularly challenging because they need to account for things like network latency, video quality, and device compatibility. They can't just test on a few laptops in their office and call it a day. Their secret weapon? Configuration management tools. They use these tools to define and enforce strict configuration policies across all their test environments. This ensured that each environment was set up identically, with the correct network settings, software versions, and device configurations. This allowed them to accurately simulate real-world streaming conditions and catch any performance issues before they reached their subscribers. The result? Smooth, uninterrupted streaming for millions of happy viewers. Section 4. The healthcare provider, saving lives with reliable software. Finally, let's shift gears to a healthcare provider. This company develops software for hospitals and clinics, software that manages patient records, schedules appointments, and even helps diagnose illnesses. Talk about high stakes. For them, software bugs aren't just an inconvenience, they could potentially have life or death consequences. They needed rock-solid test environments to ensure the safety and reliability of their software. Their solution was a multi-pronged approach. They combined IAC, containerization, and configuration management tools to create a robust testing infrastructure. They used IAC to spin up identical test environments, containerization to isolate different parts of their software, and configuration management to ensure consistency across the board. This allowed them to rigorously test every aspect of their software, from user interface functionality to complex medical algorithms. They were able to catch and fix critical bugs early in the development process, ultimately delivering life-saving software they could be proud of. Section 1. Best practices, level up your testing game. Okay, we've covered a lot of ground here. Tools are great, but they're only part of the equation. To truly master test environments, you need the right mindset and practices in place. Think of it like building a high-performance PC. You need the best components, but you also need to assemble them correctly and optimize for performance. So, let's talk best practices. These are the tried-and-true methods that'll take your testing game to the next level. We're talking about things like version control, automation, and a healthy dose of testing. Surprise, surprise. Get ready to unlock the secrets of consistent, reliable test environments. These practices will save you time, reduce headaches, and ultimately lead to better software. Let's do this. Section 2. Treat your environments like gold. Version control is key. Remember, infrastructure is code? Treat that code like the precious resource it is. Just like you wouldn't edit your game's save file without making a backup, you should always use version control for your IAC code. Version control systems like Git are your best friend here. They track every change made to your code, who made it, and when. This means you can easily roll back to previous versions if something goes wrong. Think of it like having a time machine for your test environments. Made a mistake? No problem, just jump back to a previous version. Need to see how something was configured last week? Boom! Version control has got you covered. This level of traceability and control is invaluable for maintaining consistent and reliable test environments. Section 3. Automate everything. Well, almost everything. We've already touched on automation, but it's worth emphasizing again. Automating your test environment provisioning and configuration is like having your own personal IT department working 24/7. With the right tools and scripts, you can automate the entire process of spinning up new environments, configuring software, running tests, and even tearing down environments when you're done. This frees up your team to focus on what really matters, developing awesome software. Of course, not everything can be automated yet, and that's okay. The key is to identify the most time-consuming and error-prone tasks and prioritize automating those first. Even small automation wins can add up to significant time savings and increased reliability in the long run. Section 4. Test early, test often, don't be afraid to break things. Testing shouldn't be an afterthought. It's not something you do once the software is finished and ready to ship. In fact, the earlier you start testing, the better. Think of it like building a car. You wouldn't wait until the entire car is assembled before testing the engine, right? You'd test each component individually and then integrate them gradually, testing along the way. The same principle applies to software development. Test your code frequently in small increments. Don't be afraid to break things in your test environments. That's what they're for. The earlier you find and fix bugs, the less painful and expensive they are to deal with later on. Section 1. Wrapping it up. Reliable testing, reliable software. So, there you have it. We've covered a ton of ground, from the importance of valid test environments to the tools and practices that'll make your testing life a breeze. Remember, building great software is a team effort, and having a solid testing foundation is crucial for everyone involved. Think of it like this. A reliable test environment is like having a trusty sidekick. It's always there to back you up, catch your mistakes, and help you deliver the best possible product. And who doesn't want a trusty sidekick? By investing in the right tools, automating like crazy, and embracing a culture of continuous testing, you're setting yourself up for success. You'll be able to push out updates faster with fewer bugs and keep your users happy. Section 2. Go forth and test. Now, I know what you're thinking. This all sounds great, Linus, but where do I even begin? Well, the good news is you don't have to do it all at once. Start small, pick one thing to improve, and go from there. Maybe you focus on implementing infrastructure as code for a single test environment. Or perhaps you automate a few of your most tedious testing tasks. Every little bit helps. And hey, don't be afraid to experiment and find what works best for your team and your workflow. Remember, there's no one-size-fits-all solution in the world of software development. So go forth, my friends, and conquer those test environments. The world needs your awesome software, and it needs it to be bug-free. Happy testing.